stress me out. This reorganization of finance and buildings. But it's a straightforward process. Now the next accumulation. You know, I have not actually in my life actually gone through this plan, and I'm going to be calling myself the empire or the dynasty. However, when you are in the conglomeration of these many countries, we have to have a name for it. Now the European Union is very limited by the state of Europe by what it is named as. So inclusion with Russia, inclusion with India, inclusion with the African states, all of these entities. Yes, it is past this, you know. So we are dealing with empire, and yes, hopefully the United States will include itself also. I'm really hoping they decide to, you know, that is perhaps maybe an energy that has to happen. They're pretty starved economically. So we're thinking, I won't say all, I'll say some all. So going back to the name of empire, we got dynasty, we got empire, what else do we have? We have the fallen queens and kings from before regrouping here and regaining. Are we fallen? Do we follow the power? How do we follow the power? I guess they were wars. Possibly, maybe even some were sent away into safety because of times of trouble. Not now to be king, not now to be queen, and it's too terrible. You take a few generations back, you know, go somewhere for a few generations away, and then you retain your dominance. But how, you know, in what name? I am very much so looking at the dynasties of China. is a wonderful example. We've had very many dynasties, you know, from the Tang dynasty is my favorite, I've already spoken, so because it's a cultural event dynasty. And they've had others also that are this way. But it depends what dynasty we are, you know, and then if we start saying dynasty, it's associated with a television show, which is kind of, I don't know, it's a little, you know, ruinous, isn't it? So I can't really always just say we're the de Vaux dynasty. That's just kind of yug. If we say empire, it gets ruined then also. If I say the empire of the de Vaux empire, it becomes ruined because of that movie of the Star Wars. Which side are you on, dark or light? You know. And who is your Vader? You know. And so it brings a war moment. Even that word. I prefer dynasty. They were very combative on that TV show, though, weren't they? Very combative and kind of stupid. And I don't know. It's a bummer. Those are the only choices that I can see right now. So I'm gonna stay with the dynasty one. Although I am tempted, I was tempted very much so renaming EU headquarters as a de Vaux empire. No. Going with dynasty, and yes, it has to be a head state family. It has to be a head state family of sovereign, and that is the reason why. Is it because it is owned by a group of people that are real, that are touchable and tangible, people that have emotions and feelings, people that cry, people that laugh, people that birth babies. People that are in the public eye. People that you can take a collection of with your own eyes and your own tally of who, do I really like them? Do I not like them? You know? So we are an element. We're an element of necessity. You cannot ever have any kind of global world power domination. And yes, it is a domination. It's an economic domination rule. With the stoicism of knowing who there'll be too much friction. Who are they? We will attack them. So yes, so in the wonder of this who, in the wonder of this who, this is about the freedom of it's about the freedom of many things, you know, reducing the trips to the banks for a loan, all of these things becoming another, we don't have to do this anymore, we pick our work, we pick the different jobs that are the most important, and which ones you want to profit from. So it is a worker society that does become the contribuent, becomes the contribuent too, doesn't it? It contributes to all of the others. So it is wonderful. It's wonderful. It's a great, you know, by the profits of your particular enterprise. You are earning that gladiation of extra money to save. And that extra money to save, you are an economic device that is a builder. And so you are, each person who goes to work is an extra economic builder. And so they are wonderful. They are wonderful. And now what I'm gonna say? What was I gonna say? Yeah, so I'm gonna have to stick with the dynasty one. I'll go with the Vaux dynasty, and you can be laughing and call it DVD if you want, for short. Yeah, we are DVD. So, that is funny. What else is I going to speak of? Jeez, my gosh, the arrangement, I was thinking about that TV show, huh? The marital arrangement one. That's a good one, that's a good one, huh? Yeah, so that's all it is, that's all it is. So I'm not trying to claim your sovereignty, I just have to repeat this again and again. I'm not trying to take King Yamuda's lands from him, not at all. I'm actually giving. When his lands are sold, I'm giving money to his people. There's a difference. When his lands are sold, when his properties are sold, I give money to his people. So he has less work to do, actually. He has actually less work. His government is not tied to obligations now. He can relax, and yet he can't relax because he has new obligations as a director, of fortunes, of help to the people, as a guide and a leader of his group and his languages. So and that's better. It's better, you know. So he doesn't feel so fried and frayed out into so many. Oh my gosh, you know how difficult and how easy it has been for these other kind of, these plurality governments to move in, these ones that are just dominated by enterprise. It's because it is a harsh strain on one person. It's a harsh strain. So this is the regrouping of sovereignties to lessen that harsh strain and yet maintain control of kingdoms. This is the only way we can do it. Otherwise, it is just a business office collector that does turn into Robocop, and we're not after that objective. We have to reach the people through many, many moral standings and get through it. You know, figure out how to go through the bevy of its deviances that are going on. A lot will disappear. A lot will disappear as soon as they receive this wage. They will be, I don't need the crime. I don't need to be the crimer. I don't have to go out and cause the illegal. I don't have to break into the store anymore. I will be a member of that store. I will be, I will earn money from that store, from the profits. It's a different mind that we are switching. So we are reducing the crime of mind. We are lowering that mind out, but you know, it's been trained too high to take, you know. So this is different. Yeah, And like I said, the arranged marriage thing as an example, because of peerage class, I believe we have to all do this simply because, my goodness, we have to maintain some kind of a dominion of cordialities amongst the states. And it may not be the perfect marriage matches, however, that's the way it goes. We will try to make the better ones. And I believe there will be love found amongst them. However, when we take the arranged marriages as an example to the persons, to the people, the populace, that can be a problem, can't it? It does render itself into the caste system. I'm not an advocate of a caste system belonging to every human being, every household monarchy itself, stating that yes, this is going to be my daughter to this man only, and they are married at birth, essentially as children. I am not actually for that system, because it is one system that is documented by one man to another man, as an agreement, as some kind of a business deal. It is not a group decision. It is not a group decision of marriage by other persons. And it's not a Cupid decision. It's not based on any love Cupid has made. This is for sure a match quest. They are indebted to love, obvious. You know, they are lovers. And they will respect themselves during their life. So there's nothing like that. No, it has to be a group decision. So there has to be at least a panel of persons that make a choice. Panel of persons for any arranged marriages. And I imagine that's what a little TV show I invented there, the Cupid Council, will be able to be aired all over. We'll have it in the United States, we'll have it in France, we'll have it all over. It will be in English, and it will be barbarian comedy, because that's who we are. And yes, we are comedians also. My line of people are absolute comedians. So, too bad for people who don't take us serious, but and want a serious stoic government. But comedy is is also part of our lifeline here on the world, and there's our attraction to life. If we lose our comedy, we lose who we are as people, don't we? And I have a very strong line of comedians, so I have Lucille Ball also. This is a funny one, huh? Lucille Ball to contend with. And Mr. Carey, Mr. Jim Carey there. I try to contain my face. He is quite I do feel, isn't that odd? Sometimes I'm like, I feel like he is this, before I knew that I was related to that line of person of over-dramatists in comedy, before I knew that, I already was like, I have to control my face. It's like gone crazy. It leaps all over the place sometimes, and I'm like, well, and then I find out that this guy is this name, and then I found out that I am there with the same bloodline ritual in that direction. So wow, the personality does have a push, doesn't it? It does have a push through. So yeah, we have a problem there with too many facials sometimes. So yeah. Anyway, I'm building, I've set already the directions for the new Acropolis. The new Acropolis building, which is going, after the barbarian comedy of this arrangement, marriages, 3 to 6 of them on the panel, and they do not have to do the tricks for the show or anything, but they don't even have to show up to the show. But they have to be the magic letter of these are the ones, you know, these are the 3 women that this man was choosing. He has 3 women per show to choose available. And he will. Each man will get to. He can send them into hysteric tricks if he wants. You know, make them mud bath. I don't care if the peerage class wants to mud bath out there on the stage for fun. They can do so. That is their obligation of entertainment. That's what happens when you become head family of the world. We're not pulling it any other way. We are going to be funny. So, what else was I saying? Oh, the building, the new Acropolis. Sorry, the glass builder gods out there. Sorry, I made you wait this long. I'm very entertained by a glass enclosure with the mosaic columns. The mosaic columns, tame yet similar to 100 Wasser, tame though. I want gold tiles mixed in with deep blue. Not so much green, actually. I'm not going so much into the greens, but I'm thinking that type of strain. If I do the greens, it will not be bright, vibrant greens as nuclear. They will be the darker, deeper greens. And in so more Unterklimt look, I suppose, yet not quite so much gold. Gold will only be there for the hint of. So yeah, the columns are extremely important. As the mosaic. Actually, then, and so there I am there with the glass itself, and I did say put some kind of sculpture on top of the building, a large glass shardic. And in dealing with the last, that shardic, I don't know, maybe that is too far, it just becomes a big knife sword, doesn't it? It becomes a knife sword through the heart of it, or it, you know, big glass knife, you know, which is kind of funny because that's the way we are. That's the way this particular line of a surname, a group is. And I believe when you start counting us all out, we do start saying, well, my name is kind of like this, and my name is kind of like that. We do become the cumulant army that is massive. But I'm not tapping into that right now. We're just dealing with the ones that are knowledgeable of it. We don't have to gather up all of the army of our name. That is not important. They're not prepared, they're not ready, they're not able. They've been possibly sent down other lines that way earlier that sent them astray. And so they're not able to be helpers in this time. What was I going to say? The building, glass for the god. The god I see there, the god there in his beautiful Greek toggery, yet it is something Egyptian also. It is Egyptian also. Soft, he's wearing soft outfit, a very beautiful man there in a very large room of a piano there, waiting. He's waiting for what? He's waiting for a singing show. Yes, it's a power dominion state, that place, a god, a Mount Olympus god moment. And I'm in this Mount Olympus god moment build. But not that expensive. I'm only really worried at the top of it, because if I go with the Diomo looks, it starts to look too Italy, too Vatican. If I go with that Diomo look, if we go with the Byzantine arches that are the crimped style of the Diomo. That's clever, however very quaint and Turkish, isn't it? I'm not sure that is the way to go either. I do love the churches there of that are out in the far regions of Alaska. Those are the most amazing, the rooftops. And so yeah, I'm having a bit of a fight for the rooftop design. But in classic minimalism may be where we are at the moment. We may not have this austation allow of the yomas or beautiful tierskas. So instead of this, and we're not dealing with colonialism, arch acropolis from the past that was a heathen statehood design that was just clumsy and lazy. I believe an absolute lazy build there above Athens. So I look also, funnily enough, at the sugar men, the sugar restaurateurs, the ones who create the delicacies of sugar shapes. Now the glaziers and the sugar shape creators are quite similar. So there is that possible to put those wafers of some sugar design on top. It is a little silly though, and it is excessive, and I'm not sure about doing that right now. It is interest, so I'm really dealing with a lot of glass, and we know it's hot in there, and yet also it will be a museum. This is about the Provence castle specific. It will be a museum, and oh my gosh, I want to move those catapults further even to the beach. Can we move the catapults to the beach and pull them out there for play? Much better. Move them to the beach and then we do not have to have them around the glass at all. It will be more of a museum deal. We'll have the, along the walls, we'll have to have enclosed areas that are not exposed to so much light, I know. But yes, there has to be a museum built there also. So it is available to the persons. And so we were looking at the southern Louvre with only the very best paintings. So it will be a tourist event, bringing in much money, and also an organization that will allow the Pavarottis of the world to sing. And even a little dance studio there available for the étoiles of the world who are retired to dance. That is my particular goal. All right, so Mr. God Olympus, that's a building design for these restructures. These restructures of castles that have been demolished. We're going to go with simple minimalism, with beautiful, ornate columns. It's really, I think, the cheapest way we can do it without looking cheap. So we have to go to this acolysian event. Maybe one day we can go a little more ornate. All right.